of the FGCU men's basketball program knew that the pandemic would play some sort of role in the 2020-21 season, maybe just not how much of a role it would play. By the time the Eagles play their next game later in the month, the program will have lost out on 28 days of activity to quarantine and 6 games canceled, all due to COVID-19.
So the first shot for FGCU is off the mark.
Unwelcome news in the nest Tuesday night.
Well, I think, you know, I wouldn't be human if I wasn't frustrated.
As the FGCU men's basketball program announced that someone within the team's Tier 1 group had tested positive for COVID-19, requiring a 14-day quarantine for the team for the second time this season.
The first message to our team was, you know, nobody tried to get it. This is not anybody's fault. It's just an unfortunate circumstance.
For the Eagles, they re-enter a quarantine period less than a month after exiting their first.
It's never good to get shut down, but now that we've been through it, you know, last time we didn't know what to expect.
A step backwards for a team that head coach Michael Fly believes was just beginning to find its rhythm that it lost as a result of the last 2-week pause.
It's frustrating because we felt like before we got shut down the first time, we were playing as good as anybody in this conference. We feel like, again, we're back to a rhythm of playing as good as anybody in this conference. And unfortunately, we're going to have to take another pause.
With the Eagles' next 4 games now canceled, they won't play again until February 26th. And only have 2 games to prepare for the A-Sun Conference Tournament.
We're very confident that if we're playing the way we were before the last shutdown and before this shutdown, then it could be a really fun A-Sun tournament for us.
Coach Fly also said that contact tracing determined that a few members of the Eagles did not have to quarantine. He says the challenge will once again be keeping his players in shape with 2 weeks off now. In the studio, I'm Sean Berry for NBC2.